Chase asked me for a review, so here it is. Pretty long overdue. He's professional, incredibly knowledgeable, experienced, and is absolutely qualified for the job of CFI. He's an encyclopedia of aviation knowledge. He knows systems, yes, all of them, and he's gonna make sure that you do too. He understands and respects weather, the rules and courtesies of communication, practicalities and logistics of cross-country planning, and is the only person I know that actually understands and can explain the lift equation without it being printed on their t-shirt. He can, and he will, reference any FAR. He's got the ability to jump in any airplane on the field and give you a tutorial on any piece of glass in there. He doesn't just recite, but he has demonstrated how to safely handle emergencies, and he's not going to leave you alone in an airplane until you can do the same. He will make sure you truly understand the fundamentals, maneuvers, know what and how to use all of your available resources, and will do everything he can to ensure that you have every single tool you need to succeed. He can and he will be tough on you. His expectations and standards are high. All of this makes Chase a phenomenal instructor. What makes Chase the person you want, analyzing your ADM as your mentor, your aviation advocate, your cheerleader, accountability buddy, partner, and frankly, any part at all of your aviation journey, is that he genuinely cares. He wants to see you succeed, and he's going to do everything he can to ensure that you do, to ensure that you leave him a better pilot and a safe pilot. He wants to build an aviation community, and he wants you to be a part of it and to feel like you belong to it. Maybe because I'm his girlfriend, his application of caring is a little bit amplified, but I do know whomever you are and whatever rating you're after, he will always care. On one frustrating flight where I lost a battle to autopilot, I announced that I would never love aviation like Chase, and I promised him I would never fly a stupid Cessna ever again. Rather than being frustrated or discouraged and quitting on his first private pilot student, he became really curious and committed to figuring out what exactly attracted me to aviation in the first place. Chase orchestrated a flight in an experimental airplane where he knew I would return a completely different person. No glass, no autopilot, no buttons. It was just backcountry and back to basics stick and rudder flying. He was the one that introduced me to tail draggers, to aerobatics, to vintage airplanes, and he was the one that gave me permission to hate the 172. He purposely reintroduced me to aviation, and I fell in love with it for the first time. That feeling of being absolutely electrified with excitement and terror on my first solo, returning home exhausted after my first cross-country flight, or shaking hands with the DPE as he congratulated his newest private pilot, those are the moments I owe Chase a massive thank you. The magical moment of our own airplane's wheels peeling off the earth, or finally seeing familiar terrain after 6 weeks of flying across the country, or now opening the doors on a hangar finally feels like home. I owe that to Chase. That I went from thinking I would never love aviation to believing I will never fall out of love with flying, I owe that to Chase. Thank you, Chase, for showing me an entire world I would have never given another flight. And to anyone that needs a CFI, I have no doubt that your journey with him is going to be any less impactful or with any fewer moments to thank him for.